Perfect World. The collapse of which company in 2009 affected... Let's turn that down a bit. Sam.
Woolworths.
Affected the release of the... Which, there you go, Woolworths. So, Sam, you are going to make some serious, serious hay on this round. I can guarantee it.
Another 2 points for Sam.
Yeah, he's got it. He's got it. Thoros of Myr in HBO series Game of Thrones and Bob Slay
the Night Before Christmas.
Paul K is correct. You see the way I changed that round?
I can't believe it.
I'm going to close it on you there, Sam, and film that. That's perfect reaction.
It's linked to Game of Thrones.
McPartland.
Paul K was in Game
2 points. Yeah. In which country was Anglo-Portuguese actress and model?
It's Christmas!
Sam.
Mozambique.
Yeah. Have you ever...
I was hoping you wouldn't ask me for a sir.
No, it's Mozambique, the girl with bottom... This was such a difficult subject to write for, so Sam's actually picked a real winner here, I think. You know what to do for next year, anyway. Next one. Also, by the way, next year we'll each be setting a specialist subject for another person as well. In the final episode of Perfect World, which country does the desk secretary guess Bob has been to after he greets her with aloha? McPartland.
Hawaii?
No. Rhodes?
As good as that. China?
No. Laycock?
Fiji?
No. Childs?
Tonga?
Vince?
Tahiti?
Chris?
It's Christmas!
McDonald?
Tonight before.
Not so much. Preston.
Hong Kong.
Lees.
Micronesia.
It's Christmas.
Sam.
France.
No. Ashton.
New Zealand.
Martin.
Scotland.
Scotland is the correct answer.
What? Yeah. Oh,
now. And the best thing is meant to be one of Sam's as well. What major endurance feat is completed
tonight?
The Battle of Oh, you know that programme like the back of your hand. Cross channel swim.
Steve, can you turn the thing down?
Yeah, of course I can. Tell you about that. I'm excited.
We can tell.
We're going to get deaf.
McDartmouth. By what name is marketing director's wife, Sam?
Mrs. Marketing Director.
Yes.
A dab hand with the bull whip.
Oh. It's great, like old school comedy, isn't it, marketing director? I love it. We are going. I'm sorry, this is like that for some people, I know, but what can you do when people pick a good subject? TV science fiction since 1990, A Million Hours, Perfect World, 4 hours. What name was shared by the legendary seventh and final king of Rome, reigning Laycock?
Tarquin is superbus.
Tarquin, I'm going to give you a Tarquin. Sam, can you tell them the rest of that question, what it was going to be like?
Tarquin is Bob pretends to be his twin brother to get away with something.
It's hilarious. Okay. I love that programme. In the sitcom Perfect World, we're getting to the tough ones now, by the way.
Oh, are we now?
Yeah.
Right.
In the sitcom Perfect World, what part is played by John Pertwee's daughter? Sam!
Brian.
Brian is correct. You were waiting for that one, weren't you, I presume?
Only recently found
out. Hey, do you know what? Look, what? Can you see what I've done here, Sam? 1, 2, 3, 4. But no, we're good. I thought it actually matched.
16 now.
Oh, do you know what? Can't wait for January so I can hear that noise so many times after my name's been called. Stop. How much does Bob initially owe Vaughn?
Sam.
200 quid.
Owe Vaughn in the penultimate season one. Yeah. The thing about Perfect World though is anybody could have gone and watched it and enjoyed it and done this, so.
Well, with the greatest respect, Sam's been played very carefully because he said we were asking what Perfect World is and he won't say anymore.
Only because Steve didn't say. Perfect world, I thought Steve was going to tell you.
Yeah, you could have asked me. I would have told you.
I actually alluded to it.
In fact, Michael, we did talk about what it was when you referred to the film.
I did say what it was online.
Next, let's go. Name the accounts executive who woos Maggie, played by Tom. Sam.
Spencer.
Nice 24 points, mate.
Well done.
That's a good start. General knowledge.
General knowledge, man.
Yeah, great score, mate. I expected it from you, though, nothing less. What single Greek word commonly translates as I have fat? Chris.
Eureka.
Oh, you're back.
Certainly am. Don't give my punch to Clive. Give them to me.
Can I give them to Clive?
You certainly did.
Why is that? That must be some serious kind of mental thing. I don't know.
Can I have 2 points?
Do I really hate you that much, Chris, subconsciously?
Thank you.
Do I really like you that much, subconsciously? Okay, here we go. Next one. The 1967 Marine Offences Act was inspired by what offshore activity? Laycock.
Whaling?
No, Chris.
The Torrey Canyon disaster.
Sam?
Fishing.
McPartland?
No, I was going to say fishing.
Keep going, you're free to go. Lee?
Harpooning.
Vince?
Salvaging.
Ashton?
Seal clubbing.
Martin? Preston? It was pirate radio.
Of course it was.
Oh, right.
Of course it was.
Deep breaths all round. It's a long day, I know. Connecting, can't even say this bleeding word, connecting the gastrocnemius and the soleus muscles. Chris?
Is the Achilles tendon.
It's the Achilles tendon.
Gastrocnemius and the soleus.
Clive, you've closed, and Laycock, you were in there as well. So Chris, that's a very useful point for you. Which players, a lot of football today, it is football. Which players' perhaps unique collection of trophies includes medals for the UEFA Cup, UEFA Super Cup, Intercontinental Cup, FA Community Shield, 2 Premier Leagues, 3 FA Cups with Arsenal and Portsmouth.
It's Christmas!
Sam. Nice
Christmas.
Yeah. You say his first name?
Wankwood.
Sam, that's a good answer.
Genius with the tennis ball.
You've kind of got to watch it.
Keep it.
An auriscope, A-U-R-I.
Christmas.
Ears is correct.
An auriscope.
Which model, an icon of swinging London, married photographer Michael Chris?
Twiggy.
Minus one. An icon of swinging London married photographer Michael Cox after affairs with David Bates. Ashton.
Shrimpton.
Oh, yeah.
Should
have
gone through it before you carried on. Yeah,
should
have. Annoying.
I knew it wasn't Twiggy, I knew it was the other one.
I couldn't get enough time to think of it.
What?
No.
What did I do?
Stop it. Is there a rule? He has to get it down.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Otherwise, he gets electrocuted.
Oh.
King Leontes. Sam?
Winter's Tale.
Yay! I was looking at you. Winter's Tale. Clive, why didn't you get that, mate?
Winter's Tale.
28. What's the record score for any old? 31 for Debs. Which son of Ethelred the Unready?
The Night Before Christmas.
McPartland.
Edward the Confessor?
Yeah, I was going to accept Edward on that because they only want the son, not the regnal number, but Edward the Confessor is absolutely right. Great 2 points. Takes him away from Sam, prevents him getting that record score today. Born September the 10th, I wasn't looking at you then, by the way, just a glance, 1929, in Latrobe, Pennsylvania, which golfer was a 1954 US amateur champion? Steve Rhodes. And went on to win 7 majors in 7 years between 1958 and 64. Arnold Palmer, that's a great answer, Stevie. Nothing wrong with that buzzer. It's when nobody else presses, anyway. 6 to go on this round. Whose 1967 record, Surrealistic Pillow? Right, how many people were pressing? Just one.
Hundreds.
Clive was.
New question.
Go on, give you. If there's only two of you pressing, whisper an answer to each. Jefferson?
Just an airplane.
Airplane, yeah. One each. You know, I've got to play that as I see it, and that was okay. There's nobody else involved, so 1 point each. You're both pretty quick. Please don't anybody win or lose by one bloody point. Clive, 1 point. And Mark Laycock, 1 point. That's pretty awesome answering as well. It's going. In the original Trivial Pursuit, what was the brown cat? Please.
Arts and literature.
Oh, good answer. I'm glad you got that, because I didn't want to go through that. Well, somebody would have got it eventually anyway, obviously. But 8 seconds dead. 2 points for you. You're on the board this game. Four to go. Which film director, film producer, screenwriter and actor is known for video collaborations with Fatboy Slim, Weezer, Laycock?
Spike Jonze.
What a good answer. And that went on forever and finished off with Being John Malkovich, Spike Jonze. I loved the film, was it Her, last year?
Yeah.
Oh, what a terrific film. Right, 2 points. We want to talk film sometime, Mike, I'm sure, but meanwhile, I've got to put Mark Laycock 2 points on here. And we must talk a lot of film. We should have a film special one day. Next one. What crop was grown by Fidel Castro's farm? Rose.
It's Christmas.
Huh?
Tobacco.
No, but I'll finish the question. Ashton?
Sugar.
Sugar is correct. At 4,406 feet, or 1,342 metres, which is the highest British mountain? Yeah, well, that's why I put it in there. You know what I mean? It was, you should have, well, yeah, you, I think you all knew that was coming, don't you?
Yeah,
tenths of a second and hundredths of a second between. Everybody is in the 11 second bracket there. McParkland.
That's
an extra syllable in it. One to go. Johnny and Susan Storm. Ben Grimm and Reed Richard are collectively known as what? I'm going to do a quick start and a stop, and we're going to crack on with the next round. All I'm going to do is start these and stop them.